But first, there are hundreds of species of mantis shrimp. Those are crustaceans measuring anywhere from an inch to a foot long. The peacock mantis shrimp, indigenous to the waters of Indonesia, has one specific trait that humans are trying to replicate. Chicago Tonight's Evan Garcia stopped by the Shedd Aquarium to learn more.
This peacock mantis shrimp may look small, but it packs a mighty punch. In fact, the striking motion of these crustaceans is considered the fastest in the animal kingdom.
It's not something that is mimicked in the rest of the animal world. They have these smashing arms, they're called these dactyl clubs, and these clubs are basically really, really hardened, specialized appendages at the front of their body that they use to kind of swing out and punch at velocities of up to 50 miles per hour.
The Shedd Aquarium's supervisor of special exhibits, KEOKI Burton, says that's the equivalent of humans punching through steel. In fact, special materials are used to keep the mantis shrimp from shattering aquarium glass.
Mantis shrimp not only are really powerful with those arms of smashing their prey, they can actually smash their aquarium glass as well. The exhibit that we have this animal in is actually not glass, it is acrylic, so it's a little bit more sturdy and will be a little bit more shock absorbent. Plus, that acrylic is actually 3 to 4 times thicker than the rest of the exhibits that we have here on display now.
Oh, come on.
Unfortunately, when we visited the aquarium, the shrimp wanted to eat in privacy. But the rapid strikes to smash this mussel shell are still audible. Here's some other mantis shrimp punching away.
They have these same kind of muscles as everybody else, then how can they move so fast?
That's the question Harvard graduate student Emma Steinhardt and other researchers tried to answer recently by building a robot that mimics the punch of a mantis shrimp.
So the way they're actually able to move so fast is that they store energy in a spring. But in order to sort of store energy in a spring, they need something to stop the energy flow from releasing from the spring. So they can store the energy in the spring, and they need something called a latch to basically stop that from releasing at one point. And then at some point they have a latching mechanism that basically just then releases all that energy at once. And that's how they're able to get the explosive motion.
The small spring-loaded robot is swift, but not quite as fast as Mother Nature.
We were able to get in water around like 5 meters per second, while mantis shrimp can get like 20 meters per second velocity. Nature is still winning, but give us like a year and maybe we will win. You know, nature does have some things up its sleeve that we can't necessarily do in engineering.
Steinhardt says one of the real world applications of engineering the mantis shrimp's punch is building military robots capable of punching and jumping with great force.
A lot of times, you know, biology does have a lot of really good insight because it's had thousands of years to basically try and figure out how to do these things. And so as engineers, you know, we can be able to create things that we may not be able to come up with just, you know, on a whim ourselves by actually looking at biology.
For Chicago Tonight, I'm Evan Garcia.
Pretty colorful. You may have noticed the mantis shrimp's unusual eyes. Its eyes have 12 to 16 different types of photoreceptor cells. That's at least 4 times more than humans, which means mantis shrimp are capable of seeing far more colors and types of light than we are. And in case you're wondering, yes, mantis shrimp are commonly eaten in Southeast Asian cuisine.